गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो इन लास्ट क्लास वी डिड एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, चैप्टर 4, व्हाई शुड आई लिसन. सो आई होप यू हैव रिटन दीज 3 पॉइंट्स रिगार्डिंग द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ लिसनिंग प्रॉपरली. सो एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज ऑलरेडी डन एंड यू शुड नो स्मॉल स्मॉल क्वेश्चन आंसर्स फ्रॉम द चैप्टर इटसेल्फ. And today we are going to start with exercises. These exercises you have to do in the book itself. Okay, so we are starting with exercise first and then I'll tell you what you have to do in your FAIR notebook. So starting with the exercises, first exercise is choose and tick the correct answers. So here you have been given three options. No. Yes, three options, and here is a question. You have to read the question and you have to choose which one is correct. So first one is Liz was too busy waving at. So Liz was the girl who was going out of the house with the mother, and the other girl was Pihu. So Liz was waving at whom? Her sister, a friend, her brother. So who was standing on the other side of the road? It was a friend. So answer for this is a friend. You will mark right in front of a friend. Second, mom gave Liz a sharp first option slap, second knife, third stare. So mom was giving a sharp look with a slap, knife or stare. Mom was staring at Liz because she was not listening. Third one, mother asked Liz to finish her dash first. Cornflakes, milk or kheer? We remember about the story. So mother asked Liz to finish her cornflakes first. So you will put tick in front of cornflakes and here it is stare. Fourth, Liz got poor grades in English, maths or Hindi. So it was Liz prepared for the English test, but it was maths test. So what she has got bad marks in which subject she has got? She has got bad marks in maths. By listening, Liz could make dash friends. More, no, less. So after reading the chapter, we know that if we listen properly, then only we can make more friends. So answer for this one is option A, more. Again repeating, question 1, Liz was too busy waving at a friend. Answer is B. Second, mom gave Liz a sharp stare. Answer is C. Mother asked Liz to finish her dash first. Cornflakes. Answer is A. Liz got poor grades in maths. Answer is B. By listening, Liz could make dash friends. More friends. Answer is A. So we are done with this exercise. You have to do this exercise in the book itself. Coming to the next exercise, this is fill in the blanks using the hint box. So here you have been given some hint words and you have to choose the word and you have to put in these blanks. But you have to be careful that in test or in exams, you might not get these hint words. Okay, so you have to be prepared without these hint words. You should know the answer without these hint word also. This might be the possibility that I will not give you these words, these hint words, helping words. Okay, and you have to put the blank yourself. You have to put the word in the blank yourself. I will not give you helping word or the hint box. So reading the first one, first of all we will read what all words are given in the hint box. First is fun, second is class, third is kind, fourth is nick, fifth is listening. Okay, so come to the first fill in the blank. Pihu, I got saved in the dash of time. So she got saved in the nick of time. So first one is nick, N-I-C-K, nick. You will write nick. My friends don't include me in their dash and play anymore. So they were not including them, Liz, in fun. F-U-N, fun. Third one, things got very bad when I got left out from the dash picnic. She got left out from the class picnic. C-L-A-S-S. Fourth one, dash to a grown-up will keep me out of danger and trouble. Listening to grown-up, L-I-S-T-E-N-I-N-G. Listening to a grown-up will keep me out of danger and trouble. Last, I listen to others as it is kind and polite. K-I-N-D, kind and polite. So again repeating, first one, Pihu, I got saved in the nick of time. Second, my friends don't include me in their fun and play anymore. Third, things got very bad when I got left out from the class picnic. Fourth, listening to a grown-up will keep me out of danger and trouble. Fifth, I listen to others as it is kind and polite. So students, we are done with second exercise also. You have to do this exercise in the book itself, and you have to prepare this exercise, you have to learn this exercise without these hint words. You will not get these hint words in the test or in the exam. Okay, now coming to the word meaning, I'll tell you how you have to start with the word meaning. Now first of all, I will help you to read the word meaning, and then I will tell you how you have to do it in the notebook. So first word meaning, waving, move one's hand to and fro in greeting or as a signal. So waving is when we move our hand to and fro like this we do if we are saying hi, hello. So to and fro in greeting or as a signal, when sometimes it happens with us that we are calling someone, if the person is far away, we shout and we wave our hand that I am standing here. So we wave our hand as a signal also, or giving as a greeting also, like saying hi, hello. Okay, second, pavement, a raised path on the side of a road. A raised path means a path which is little up in comparison to the main road, the pakka road. Okay, nick, just in time, like in a click. Okay, stare, look fixedly at someone. When we look at someone for a minute or so, like we stare at someone. Okay, it happens usually when we are looking at someone with more interest, or sometimes it happens when we are angry and we stare at someone. Okay, now next one, bore means dull. Okay, bore, when we say I am bored, that means we are feeling dull. Next is grades, marks. We always say na, how many marks or how many grades you have got. So this grades are marks. Politeness, showing good manners toward others. Politeness is we are showing good manners towards other. Nod, move the head up and down to show agreement. Sometimes when we do not speak by mouth, we nod our head saying yes or no. So this is nod or nodding. Interrupt means disturb. Distracted means unable to pay attention to somebody. Distracted means when we are unable to pay attention, when we are not listening to someone who's saying something. Okay, so these are the word meaning. Now look at this. For example, this is your fair notebook, English fair notebook. What you have to do with your pencil, I'm writing it with pen, but you'll use pencil. You will write chapter, chapter number. This is chapter number 4, and the name of the chapter is Why Should I Listen? Okay, this is the chapter name. You can see this from your book itself. It is written over here, Why Should I Listen? And here they have put question mark. So what you have to do, you have to write chapter 4, Why Should I Listen? And you have to put date also. Like here you have to write, for example, the day you're writing it, you have to put the date of that particular day. For example, you are doing it on 3rd July 2020. Okay, the day you are writing this in your fair notebook, you will write the exact date. Okay, I'm doing it on 3rd, so I'm writing it on 3rd July. The day you'll be doing it in the fair notebook, you will be writing the date of that particular day. Okay, now you will write the heading, word meaning. Okay, this is the heading. Now what you have to do, you will write one, and you will write waving, waving. Okay, put a dash and you will write the meaning. Move one's hand, hand, to and fro in greeting or as a signal. This is how you have to write word meaning. Okay, then you have to leave one line and then you have to write the second one. You can see from here, second is pavement. Same, you will write pavement this side, ment, and you will write the answer this side. Here you will write the answer. So this is how you have to do all your word meanings, leaving one line and you'll finish the word meaning. Okay, I'm writing second one also for you. Pavement means a raised path on the side of a road. Okay, you will write neat and clean, no hurrying up, no spelling mistakes. If you're making any spelling mistake, erase it properly and then again write it. Okay, again you will leave a line and then you will write the third word meaning. Third one meaning is nick, n-i-c-k, and you will remember while writing you have to put the first letter capital and then small, capital and then small, and here also you will start with capital and then small. Okay, so this is how you will write all the word meanings. We have 1 2 three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. 10 word meanings you have. So you will write the serial number. You will write word here. You will put a little dash, and then you will write the meaning. And then you have to leave one line. After every word meaning, you have to leave a line. So this is how you will finish the word meaning, all the 10 word meanings. Nick means just, in time. So today what we did, first of all we did this exercise. This you have to do it in the book itself. And then we did second exercise, B exercise. This also you have to do it in the book itself. But we did one more thing, which is word meaning. Word meaning you have to do in your FAIR notebook, English FAIR notebook. And you have to first of all write chapter number, chapter name, and you have to write the date. The date should be of the same day when you are doing it in your FAIR notebook. Don't copy my date. You have to write it on the day, the particular day you are writing it. Okay, don't copy my date. Okay. And then you will heading would be word meaning, and you will do it in a neat and clean handwriting like this. We have 10 word meanings. You will finish all the 10 word meanings. That's it. It might happen that these all 10 word meanings will not come on a single page. You can use the second page also. So don't worry for the pages. You have to write neat and clean handwriting. Okay. You can in fact underline this. Okay. To specify that these are the word meanings. So we are done with the reading of the chapter. We are done with the explanation of the chapter. We have done word meaning in notebook. We have done exercise A and exercise B in the book itself. So that's all till now for this chapter. We'll continue this because we are not done with the chapter. More exercises are left, question answers are left. But till now you have to finish this much only, okay? And you have to do it in a neat and clean handwriting in your FAIR notebook also, and in your this book also. So that's all for this chapter, and thank you for the class.